The Addis Ababa to Djibouti Railway is Africa's first fully electrified train line and has been built entirely according to China's railway standard. The line is about 760 kilometers long and designed for speeds of up to 120 kilometers per hour. Chinese standards were adopted during the construction of the railway, as well as all the technical equipment coming from China. In order to suit the natural environment and local people's needs, the Chinese construction team has relied a lot on localized design for this railway. Djibouti is mainly hot and dry due to its tropical desert climate. Wen Jintao, who is responsible for the construction of the Djibouti section of the Addis Ababa to Djibouti Railway, came here to do the preliminary survey. He understood quite profoundly the Chinese phrase, "A path appears only when thousands of people walk through it."
都是道路的荒芜的，很多人都迷路，因为走到这个地方的话，你根本就不分，这个地方当时是荒无人烟。咱们吉布提到的话，才只有80多公里，在埃塞那段的话有300多公里，总共400多公里的路程，所以全靠步行，没有任何变道的情况下，咱们修到这条变道。咱们就沿线呢，在修边道的时候的话，每个地方你看这个。
Addis Ababa, the capital of Ethiopia, sits at one end of the line. It then runs through cities and pastures. In order to minimize the impact on those living near the line, the railway was designed and constructed using 447 culverts and 61 bridges in total, with 2 channels per kilometer. Now, all the trains running on this new standard track also come from China.
所有车辆均采用国内成熟车型为原型车，针对亚吉铁路高原、高温、多雨、长大坡度等不同路段的复杂情况，对各车型进行了深性改造。我们进入那个。 埃塞和吉布提管道的时候，那个进入这个封沙区了，有强劲的封沙好了，能见度很差。这种极端封沙情况做了多层防风沙过滤设计，这种三层过滤设计的话，可以免受这种强风沙侵入到机车内部，也有效地保护了电气和通风冷却系统。
This is the brand new Addis Ababa to Djibouti Railway. China helped build an electrified railway, bringing its advanced train technology here. This railway will not only speed up the economic development of two of the world's most underdeveloped countries, but also change local people's lives.